I'm going to start this lecture series with a review of some algebraic basics. These are some facts that students sometimes forget. Sometimes they get them mixed up. Sometimes they've heard the language used kind of in a sloppy way, and so they've kind of learned things incorrectly. But most importantly, I want to show you how I do these problems, basic problems, because I'm going to be using certain shortcuts throughout the entire course, and I want you to be familiar with them and understand how they work. So I'm going to orient this introduction around two basic words. The first is a term, and the second one is a factor. Now, by term, I mean what we call a term in algebra, not in general English and not in other areas of mathematics, but just in an algebra course, what do we call a term and what do we call a factor? So we'll start with terms. Terms are quantities that are added or subtracted, or single quantities. Now, honestly, you could just say that they're quantities that are added, because of course subtracting is just adding a negative. Single quantity, you can think of as a single quantity plus zero. So it's being added to zero in a sense, but you don't have to think of it that way. It's easier just to think of it as a single quantity. I'll show you an example of those in a minute, but first, terms that are being added and subtracted. So here I have 2x. Let me get my pointer going the right way. Here I have 2x. That's a term of the left side of this equation. The negative 3, or minus 3 if you want, is a term of the left side of this equation. The 3x is a term of the right side of the equation, and the 1 is a term of the right side of the equation, because these are being added, these are being subtracted. Okay, now this is also a term, because this is a single quantity. So x is a term of the left side of the equation. 3 is a term of the right side of the equation. Okay, let's look at x minus 3 over x plus 1. X is a term of the numerator of this fraction, as is negative 3. X is a term of the denominator of this expression, as is 1. X is not a term of this whole expression. In fact, this whole expression is a term. So there's different levels. There's the big level, and then there's, as you break down into smaller parts of it. So the numerator has two terms. The denominator has two terms, X and 1. The whole thing is just a single term. It's this plus zero, if you want, right? Okay. X over 4 plus X over 3, there are two terms there. The first one is X over 4, and the second one is X over 3. That's two terms, they're being added. X is not a term of the whole thing. X is a term of the numerator of x over 4. 4 is a term of the denominator of x over 4. X is a term of the numerator of x over 3. 3 is a term of the denominator of x over 3. Right? But 3 is not a term of x over 3 because it's not being added to x. It's being divided, actually, x divided by 3.